Notre Dame Cathedral's iconic rose windows are in good shape, but what's supporting them are at risk. And outside faithful came together last night to pray. This morning, a crane and wood arrived at the church as repair work began. Firefighters say they're still figuring out how much damage was done to the structure, and they're being very careful when inside. Nearly $1 billion in donations has poured in since Monday's blaze. French President Emmanuel Macron wants to rebuild within 5 years, but experts and even other government officials worry that timetable is not realistic. Renovations will include the famed 19th century spire and two-thirds of the roof. President Donald Trump offers to help both Pope Francis and President Macron. He tweets, "Just had a wonderful conversation with Pope Francis, offering condolences from the people of the United States for the horrible and destructive fire at Notre Dame Cathedral. I offered the help of our great experts on renovation and construction, as I did in my conversation yesterday with President Emmanuel Macron of France. I also wish both Pope Francis and President Macron a very happy Easter." An American Catholic priest says the disaster is a reminder God is with us. Father Roger Landry writes in the National Catholic Register, praying that the holy nostalgia the French and others have for Notre Dame will awaken their religious memory and ultimately revivify their desire to enter into the Christian memorial. For more on this story, including Father Landry's favorite memories from his 7 trips to the cathedral, visit the National Catholic Register at ncregister.com. Now let's talk about what it will take to rebuild Notre Dame. Catholic architect Art Lohsen is author of Rebuild My House, A Guide to Building or Renovating a Catholic Church. Arthur, welcome to the broadcast.
Thank you, Jason.
So President Macron says 5 years, others say not even possible. What do you say?
Well, it took 100 years and more to build Notre Dame. There's no rush to rebuild it on any artificial timetable. We should take our time and build it well.
So the materials, some of them old wood, the old glass, I mean, these things, we don't even have those materials any longer. How are they going to rebuild this structure with new materials?
Well, the important thing to remember is that the skill set, the technology is still here to rebuild this building as it was built originally. It's probably not economically and from a scheduled standpoint feasible to try to rebuild this out of old growth oak timbers. They're just simply not available as they were centuries ago. But it can be done with a steel frame, modern materials. But from our perspective, it should be done in a way that's timeless, that maintains the timeless character of Notre Dame Cathedral, because that's its most important point.
So will there be the artisans, will there be the craftsmen that can actually redo this work from centuries ago, Gothic structure?
Absolutely. We work with them every day in designing Catholic churches around the world. The interesting thing about a project like this, even though it's a tragedy, it's an opportunity, particularly if we take our time to train the artisans and craftsmen, give them the opportunity to spend the time that it takes to restore and renew this cathedral properly.
So right now the firemen are going in, they're trying to analyze and see if the structure's supportive for them to get in and do more work. I mean, what are the next steps of this process that you're saying might take a century, Macron says may take just 5 years?
Well, the real answer is it probably takes somewhere between the 5 years and the century. But the important point is there shouldn't be any rush. The next steps are to stabilize the structure, make sure that the damage is contained. The wonderful thing about an old building like this is the way it was constructed, the walls are designed to support themselves. The roof was not installed in a series of weeks like a modern building would. So those walls are originally designed to support themselves. So as long as they're stable and stabilized, we can take our time to design and install a new roof.
Last question. Your firm has been working on Catholic churches for many years now, and it actually led to you converting to the Catholic faith. Can you tell us really briefly about that?
It did. In how many minutes do we have to do that in?
It's not a short story. We need about 30 minutes, right?
Right, at least. It's what brought me to the church was the opportunity of working on beautiful Catholic churches here in Washington and around the world. And the beauty of those places, the ability to experience the presence of God through the transformative power of beauty, is what led me to become Catholic.
a conversion story based on beauty. What a beautiful story to share with us. Thank you so much for your time today. We really appreciate it.
You're welcome, Jason. Thank you.